it's all right. It's all right. It's all right.
Tab Benoit is one of the hottest Cajun musicians to rise out of steamy southern Louisiana. He's released 17 albums, earned a Grammy nomination, received 7 Blues Music Awards, and he's been featured on scores of magazine covers.
It's good to spread it around, you know, spread the music out to people and give them a taste of Louisiana.
When it comes to cranking out the swampland blues, no artist delivers that raw bayou flavor like this bluesman. Benoit is famous for his heavy-handed guitar solos on his vintage Fender Telecaster.
I'm a drummer first. I feel like I'm a drummer on a guitar, so I play drum things on a guitar instead of thinking guitar stuff. Yeah, so rhythm is a big part. And, you know, it's a big part of the music where we live. That's one thing that kind of sets Louisiana apart is all the different rhythm stuff. And everybody's a good drummer. I try to be a product of the environment that I'm in, you know, and let it, let the moments kind of move me whichever way it's going to go, you know. And that always seems to be able to draw the audience in together with me so that it's not just me putting on a show, it's us having a moment together.
Cajun music is all about making you dance and making you move and making you feel something. Yeah. I can't wait to learn to play some.
In my boat in the cypress tree. Hey, they're gonna see me.
Benoit's songwriting rituals take him deep into the Delta. It is at a secluded campsite where he channels the spirit of the bayou.
The only method I got is just to get away from, man-made things for a minute and go to my camp and do the writing over there so that I'm not, you know, distracted or influenced by something else, you know, just let whatever I'm feeling happen, you know, just to try to keep it natural.
Take me home. Got the fever for the bayou. Muddy water, take me home. I get high on a mountain.
Fans have unheard access to Tab. He can usually be found hanging outside his tour bus between shows.
Maybe I'm not an artist. Maybe I'm just a dude that plays guitar and, you know, just one of y'all, you know, because that's the way I feel. This just happened to be my job. Everybody's got their job and everybody's got a talent. And it's not special to be talented, you know. I think the only thing that's special is understanding that what your talent is and you know, giving it its due, doing the right thing with it, you know.
Tab Benoit's relentless efforts to save Louisiana's eroding coastline landed him a starring role in the IMAX film Hurricane on the Bayou.
Have you ever loved a place so much that you dedicate your life to saving it? You know, I believe that my highest calling is to be the steward of my environment. My first job was as a pilot. From up here, the awful truth hits you. These wetlands are disappearing right before our eyes. That island there, that used to be a sugar plantation a mile wide. Erosion caused by wind and waves has reduced it to just a sliver.
The project ended up documenting one of America's worst natural disasters, Hurricane Katrina. As the founder of the organization Voice of the Wetlands, Tab describes the venture as a life-changing experience.
It started 2 years before Katrina, so, you know, it was called Hurricane Warning the whole time we were filming it, and it was all about warning people about what would happen if a major hurricane hit the coast of Louisiana, in particular how bad off New Orleans was and how vulnerable it was. And then it happened while we were filming this movie. Everything that we talked about came true, so it was, you know, It was a crazy feeling. It was almost like, you know, it almost felt like we made it happen because we had talked about it so much and it came true, you know what I mean, in a big way.
But it's so hard to drive with these tears in my eyes, and it takes a long time to get to Baton Rouge. And all I want is to hear somebody play my song when a Cajun man gets the blues.
You know, if it was physical healing, it would be different, but you know, that's what everybody looks at. It's not, it's bigger than that, you know? Those were big moves by federal government. It's so much more in, you know, embedded and deep than just fixing some houses and rebuilding some levees, and you know, it's way bigger than that. Nobody else knew about this stuff because it's not on the news. And you know, we knew about it, and I've been screaming about it. I've been screaming to Congress about it, and the local government and the state government, going, what are we doing? You know, what are we doing? Look what we have in front of us. It's a no-brainer here. You know, something's gotta be done, it's gotta be done now. What are you doing? I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna jump in and use whatever tools I have to make some noise and get this fixed. All of this stuff is an exercise in democracy and freedom, real freedom. The freedom to be a part of the government, and we have that. It's a free, open forum, you know, and that's what it needs to be able to get the truth told so that we can make the big decision, you know. Are we moving? Are we fixing? The truth is that New Orleans, that area is sinking because we're losing the Delta, and we're losing it fast. It's an acre an hour, you know. So it's a ridiculous amount of land. And it's a man-made problem. The Gulf is reclaiming what the Mississippi River built because we channeled the river out of the Delta. It's not continuously building like it's supposed to.
I want to tell you just how I feel. I had a dream, baby, and I thought it was real. I woke up in love, and now you're all I can think of.
As Louisiana works to restore its land, the music of Tab Benoit delivers healing to the people of New Orleans.
Things happen. You know, like big things, like a Katrina thing, you know. People, we've been through stuff there, so people pick up and get stronger and get better, and the music gets better. And, you know, I mean, the music right now in New Orleans is just, it's on a new little, like, you know, push and move, you know. Need this, you know, it's the real heartfelt, you know, elixir or whatever you need, you know, this is the real soothe your soul stuff, and because we know, we've been through it, we know what you're feeling, here's some of it back at you, you know, and in a good way though, you know, in a positive way to take the blues, you know.
I just want to take you, baby. Oh, to the fatal door, where we can dance on it till we can't stand no more. Yes, and we could do it for a while, Louisiana style.